From the moment humanity was able to conceive of a better place, we've been on the move, constantly flowing, searching for the promise of sturdy shelter, good work, and safe harbor. In recent years, Germany has been one of the main recipients of that humanity, taking in over 1.6 million refugees since 2014, more than all the other EU countries combined, and Berlin is at the center of that migration. Based in Berlin, Ready School offers technology classes for refugees ranging from basic web design to advanced coding and gets them into the workplace. Ready School invited me as a guest lecturer and I decided to arrive early to learn more about how they, along with tech companies like the language app Babbel, has set out to remove some of the barriers that refugees face when arriving in a new place, a place they hope to call home. Our planet and our civilizations are changing faster than ever before. Join me as I travel the globe talking to startup founders using technologies to make our world more interesting, accessible and livable. These are the entrepreneurs that are creating the future we will live in. This is Now Go Build. There are few cities in the world with as much experience with refugees as Berlin. As far back as Frederick the Great encouraging people of all faiths and backgrounds to make Berlin their home through the modern cases of World War II and the influx of East Germans to West Berlin during the Cold War. Berlin has seen its fair share of refugees moving in and out. Today, they arrive from all over the world, encountering obstacle after obstacle, walls, wire, lines drawn on maps, all barriers in the path to freedom. Now, technology offers new solutions. Rami, a graduate of the Ready School, was one of the people that made the trip from war-torn Syria. Now a successful coder and entrepreneur at the beginning of his career, he agreed to tell us his story.
Hi, I'm Rami. Nice meeting you. Welcome to Berlin.
So how long have you been working here?
I've been working here for 2 years.
You're one of the great stories of success from the Ready School. So tell us a bit how you got here at all.
Yeah, so at the end of 2015, there were reasons to get out. But one day I started to get second thoughts. And then my brother, he was just, come on, man, don't right now chicken out, just do it. And the same day, I just went, I bought a backpack. We found a bus, and I told him, okay, I will just take this bus and see what happens. And this was the worst part, getting out of this area to the other areas, and then to the borders, and then to Turkey. When I was on the borders in Turkey, we could not get in, and they took like my military book, and they just teared it down. And that means that there is no coming back. We found a new route, but it's dangerous. And then I tried it and it worked. I got into Turkey and then from there I went to Izmir, which is like on the beach. And then I got into the boat. People think when you actually get into the boat, that's like the scary part. But I'm a really good swimmer, so. And then I got to Greece and I was like, right now I'm gonna go to Germany. I didn't know which city. I didn't plan that far ahead. And I called my brother and he was like, well, you can't go wrong with Berlin. And I was, okay, let's come to Berlin. And I just came to Berlin.
So did you really have a plan then, what you were going to do here?
I had no clue. I got into a basketball court with like 300 people. It was a great place. I was pretty happy because it was safe.
This is the center where we're staying. Guys are helping us.
I mean, I was pretty grateful that we have this, but it was not something for me to stay there.
Did you already speak English before you actually came to Germany?
When I was in Syria, I was always speaking to my brother in English, watching TV shows, movies. Okay. Like, I like Matthew McConaughey, who said like, all right, all right, all right.
So how's your German?
My German is pretty good.
Language can be a barrier, just like a wall or a border. Rami survived the journey to a new home, only to be stuck without the words to move forward. It was technology that bridged that gap. The language app Babbel has not only created a fantastic new way to learn a new language, they've curated programs and credits specifically for refugees to get started on their language skills so they can get an education and can get into the working market. We were very fortunate to visit the Ready School here, yes, which is all about sort of helping refugees learn IT skills. But language learning was tremendously important as well. There's a large refugee population in Berlin. Yeah. Have you guys worked with them as well?
Yeah, so especially around the peak times, I think like 2 years ago when there was that big refugee crisis hitting Germany or Berlin especially, we helped out by providing access to our paid courses. So we gave out over €1 million in our subscriptions. And we not just gave that away, but we actually sent people from within Bubble to help refugees just arriving using the app and installing it. And so that was a big initiative within the company. We wanted to make sure we can do everything to help in that area.
Very cool. You guys have taken a pretty unique approach to learning. Is analytics an important part and also how you structure your next products or how you improve your products?
I think that was from the very beginning super inspiring that for the first time you could really observe how people would actually use our courses, how they would interact with certain elements. So we look at all of that data, all of the feedback that we get from our users and make sure there is that round trip. So we iterate on all of the courses that we have all the time.
So how has that evolved over time?
What the cloud allowed us to do was to move up in terms of our value creation. Mm-hmm. Still remember the time when we did the MySQL hosting ourselves and the whole replication things across different hosts was so painful, it would break all the time and it would get people woken up in the middle of the night. And with all the managed service, I think we're really able to spend that manpower in a much, much better way, which is taking care of the learning part and not on managing the infrastructure.
And there's a lot of talk about sort of how to use automated speech recognition, natural language understanding, text to speech, all those kind of tools. Are you guys using any of those as well?
One area is around error classification, because especially on mobile, I have like a big thumb, so sometimes it's pretty easy to make mistakes. But then the question is that a mistake that you make just by mistaping, or is that like something more going on in your brain? Like that you didn't get any grammar constructor. So there has been quite a lot of progress in the NLP area around classification of errors.
Is there an advantage to being in Berlin as a language startup?
Yeah, because we're doing all of the content in-house, we need to find all these translators and people actually working on the content side. And if you try to hire a Portuguese speaker who also speaks Swedish at the same time, I don't think there's that many places in the world where you can find these people.
Okay. Yeah, so it's very human intensive. It's not just tech.
That was probably my biggest learning curve because I'm a techie by heart. I studied computer science and I was always into like building products and technology. But what really made the difference for us was to see that there's that other part around language learning, which really takes care of humans, which takes care of helping people to express themselves. It's about connecting with other people.
How did you find Ready?
I did a check-in on Facebook saying that I'm in Berlin. And a friend of mine was like, what the hell are you doing in Berlin? And so we started like going to events together, exploring the city. And then one day he called me and he told me there's a new school that will give you laptops. Like a laptop was a huge thing. Like you'll have even teachers that will teach you how to program.
Started in the wake of the migrant crisis of 2015, founders Anne-Claire Richert and Ferdy van Heeren recognized that these new arrivals needed more than a donation drop box. They needed work. And Berlin needed these people, specifically in the tech sector. It was a match that Anna and Ferdy were eager to make.
So when did you guys start?
So the idea came in the middle of what is called the refugee crisis in Europe. So in the summer of 2015, I was in a refugee camp. I was invited to the end of Ramadan to celebrate, and I was sitting next to a young man from Iraq. And Mohammed told me about his life, what his dreams were, and that he really wanted to work here, but that he didn't have a laptop. And I thought, wow, I've got at least two old laptops at home, and they might not be the fastest, but they still work. And that's when the idea started coming together. I then went back home, put a post on Facebook and said, if I start a coding school for refugees, would you help? I went to bed, not thinking much about it, and the next morning there was just this outpour of people who are like, I have space, I have a laptop, I can teach. And that was sort of the first proof of the concept.
And for me, that was the personal motivation. growing up in South Africa and then also traveling to Mozambique and seeing firsthand the devastation caused by civil war, this was a topic that was very close to my experience. So when we looked at the challenge that Germany was facing, we really zeroed in on the fact that technology had the ability to address this in a way that nothing else could. When I moved to Germany in 96, I remember being excluded very strongly because I couldn't speak German. So I would go and apply for a job as a cleaner in a local cafe. And they would say, no, sorry, we put a lot of value on our team. And because you can't speak the language, we can't really have you. And if I was experiencing that level of discrimination, right, I was like, I can't even begin to conceive under the political context that people were coming in, how they handle integration.
So tell me a bit about your students.
Oh yeah, there's a lot that can be said about our students. First of all, they come from 43 different countries, so we usually like to call them a small United Nations. The average age is about 30. Right now, I'm so happy that we have 40% women in our courses. My goal is still to have 50% women, because I think that's what the world looks like, and that's also what the tech world should be like. After leaving Ready School, we can see about 50% of our students will get jobs, part-time jobs, working as freelancers. About 20% go back to university to complete their degrees, and 6% start their own startup, which is really exciting. So I think that entrepreneurial feeling that they get here at Ready School is also something that makes them believe, wow, I can go out and do this as well.
So I joined Klöckner as an intern, and from there they offered me like a full-time job contract and first QA, and then I moved like to a developer. So I'm working full-time, and then I have also multiple projects that I started, and that's what I'm trying to do. Wie kann ich gut Volleyball spielen? Ehrlich zu sagen.
Auf einer Skala von 1 bis 10 bist du
11, siehst du? Ist ein ehrlicher Mann. Ehrlich.
Berlin. It's very multicultural. It's people coming from everywhere, coming together, and at the same time, because of the history of Berlin, massive changes is something that the city has lived through many times. When you put those two things together, it definitely creates a very special environment where people want to help out, want to see new opportunities together.
Thank you all for being here tonight. What I decided to do is actually talk a bit about machine learning. The challenges are with machine learning is that traditionally machine learning has been the domain of data scientists. And this is something that basically went on in Amazon for almost 20 years. And so our goal is to get machine learning in the hand of every developer.
There's 82,000 open IT positions in Germany alone.
Yeah, I think if you are looking for a career, this is a great time to be in IT.
You know, this is one of the few jobs where you can go to work every day and create something new, yeah, or build something and be building things.
It seems unlikely that the flow of humanity is going to stop anytime soon. Ensuring that people have new opportunities to integrate and contribute to the new communities to make them their own is work that needs to happen. Work that Babbel and the Ready School have taken on. While the world still has plenty of borders, walls and barriers, it's good to know that technologists, educators and visionaries like Anna, Ferdi and Thomas are knocking some of those walls down.
Our planet and our civilizations are changing faster than ever before. Join me as I travel the globe talking to startup founders using technologies to make our world more interesting, accessible and livable. These are the entrepreneurs that are creating the future we will live in. This is Now Go Build.